certainly has been interesting stepping away from negative influences on the internet. It's been very interesting. It's been probably 99% positive. The negative side is it's kind of boring, but it allows me to focus on other things. I just didn't realize how much I was addicted to negativity. I would seek it out. Why would I do that? Why would I do that to myself? But I would just keep doing it. You know, well, it keeps my mind active, I suppose. But if you create patterns of looking for negative things, I mean, that's how you're changing your brain to be more negative. That doesn't seem like a very good thing to do. Stepping away from this does leave a bit of a void, but I can eventually figure out a way of filling that void. You know, if I'm going to focus on injustices in the world, there's an infinite supply. I should pick and choose wisely what I'm going to be upset or outraged at. Man, I've lost count now. How many people I've unsubscribed from now over the past few days. Just like, nope, I don't need that. One of the more recent ones is, what is his name? The Amazing Lucas. Actually, he's the main one that made me go, you know, if I'm gonna unsubscribe from him, which is worth it, I'm gonna unsubscribe from a bunch of others too. But he made a video just like, it's supposed to, his focus is on a particular subject, but the things that you listen to him say along the way tell you what his mindset really is. And yeah, I'm just not going to listen to the opinion of someone who thinks that LGBT should have no dignity, that we should be not accepted everywhere and just be satisfied that there aren't laws against us. It's essentially the message. It's that same kind of message. He doesn't say it. He would be very careful. He'd say, I'm not saying this. But it's the same sort of argument as, oh, well, at least they're not throwing you off buildings. You should be happy that they're not throwing you off the roofs of buildings. You're not being lynched, so be happy. I saw that this video of his that just showed how he really feels, that not even churches should have open arms for LGBT, right? No, churches should shun them. Make them know their sinful ways. Okay, whatever. I'm going too long about the guy. That's why I was just like, you know, this is too much energy to be spending on someone who thinks that highly of himself in every regard. I mean, even his name, The Amazing Lucas. He certainly thinks he's amazing. Oh my goodness. Oh yes. Right? A whole number of others, though, you know, like Vincent James, Red Elephants, Paul Joseph Watson, a number of channels that have Patriot in the name, number of channels that have Liberty in the name. I also unsubscribed from The Amazing Atheist because on Twitter, he now uses a block bot to block anyone who follows Cult of Dusty. Yeah, bye-bye. Bye. He used to complain about people like Steve Shives and a bunch of others who did the same thing, but it's okay if he does it, right? No, that's all right, man. Unsubscribe. Sorry. Number of channels that try to claim that they're the real news. I mean, it's funny. When people are grifters, they somehow want you to believe that they're not grifters, first off, but they want you to believe that if it's independent media being grifters, that that's much better than when mainstream media are grifters. Because mainstream media definitely has that sort of thing going on. They just want to try to make as much money as they can, so they'll do anything they can to get the views, you know, under certain standards. So when those standards are no longer required and you can just state anything you want to get views, is that supposed to be a whole bunch better? Sorry, I don't buy into that anymore. Sorry. And so often, and I've been guilty of this as well, you know, there'll be a subject that the person speaking doesn't know jack shit about. Knows surface layer information about something, and well, I've got to state my opinion. Great, well, what good does that do? If it's not very knowledgeable on a subject. You know, what good does it do if the person is rather ignorant about the subject? Again, I've been guilty of this too, and I regret it. Now, I'm not doing this to just people. I'm not, you know, unsubscribing from just people on the right. I've also unsubscribed from channels like The Young Turks and Ring of Fire and any of the ones that are in the Young Turks family. Except Secular Talk. Isn't he associated with TYT in some way? Maybe not. I thought he was. Anyway. He seems to be the reasonable one out of any of them. Yeah, there's a whole shit ton of smaller channels, though, that I can't remember the names of. Just unsubscribe. Done. Don't want to see it anymore. Look what Trump is doing! Look what the left is doing! Look what Trump is doing! Look what the left is doing! Look what... Oh, shut up. You know? In actuality, things aren't really going that bad. When you look at the way that people in other countries are having to live, this country isn't doing that bad. We're not... I mean, we could be doing better. We could always be making improvements. But, I mean, there's a point when you have to be at least somewhat satisfied with what you've got. Because think about what it would be like if you didn't have that, right? You know, sometimes you don't know what you've got until it's gone. So. And this, and I'm speaking of the fear-mongering going on both sides. Like I said, it's look at the left versus look at what Trump's doing. Tired of the whole fucking thing. Maybe people are saying, oh, you're apathetic. Well, you know, there's a certain amount of apathy that's required, or you could drive yourself crazy looking at all the injustices and wrongdoings that are going on across the world. There's too many to think about. You know, pick and choose wisely. What do you want to be bent out of shape over? You know, what's important enough to be bent out of shape over, I should say. Yeah, I'm tired of the sensationalist crap. I'm tired of the propaganda-style crap. I'm tired of this side versus that side. Just tired of it. I'm also tired of trying to pretend that some of these positions that people have on the right, some of the positions, that taking a stance between the right's position and the left's position is a balanced, that's where the center is. No, that's not often where the center is. I mean, it's like when, you certainly can't say that intelligent design. We should teach intelligent design. Look, we're presenting creationism in a different light. So you have to look at it as just as valid as evolution, right? It's like, no. Or, climate change isn't really happening. And if it is, humans have nothing to do with it. But yeah, that's not a very reasonable position either. I mean, you could say that humans have less to do with it than some people are saying. Okay, that could be a fair argument. But when you're saying that it's humans have virtually no effect on it, oh, give me a fucking break. The statistics are not with you. They're with the people saying, hey, yeah, climate change is happening and humans have quite an effect on it. You know, but trying to have a middle ground on that kind of position, no, that doesn't work. Sorry. That's not the middle. You know, when you're dealing with, if one side is truth, the other side is false, yeah, you're going to take a kinda position.